This is the first in a series of three videos to accompany the Operative Nuances manuscript on extended middle fossa and middle fossa approaches. The case selected for demonstration is a patient with chronic tick-like facial pain due to a petrous apex meningioma invading Meckel's cave. This is the pre-op MRI scan. After incision and scalp elevation, the temporalis muscle and fascia are retracted anteriorly, clearing out this area. The bone flap is planned, shown here, extending above the level of the squamosal suture. I prefer to make this craniotomy by drilling troughs in order to minimize the potential for dural disruption, which is critical in maintaining the integrity of the temporal lobe when retracting it extradurally. These troughs are drilled and thinned with a coarse diamond burr, and the bone flap is elevated and carefully separated away from the dura. Any remaining lip overhanging the floor of the middle fossa is removed. The dura is elevated beginning lateral and posterior along the petrous ridge. It's important to completely elevate the dura away from the petrous ridge to adequately set the retractors. Elevation is from lateral to medial, exposing the arcuate eminence and the meatal plane. Then the elevation occurs from posterior to anterior, exposing the greater superficial petrosal nerve, dividing the middle meningeal, and as seen here, elevating the dura propria away from V3 and the lateral portion of the Gasserian ganglion, and exposing the trigeminal impression lateral border. Here the arcuate eminence is seen, the greater superficial petrosal nerve, and the internal auditory canal along the bisection axis of their two planes. The bone drilling begins here, lateral to the trigeminal impression along the petrous ridge.